By the end of this video, you will be able to design multiple bar charts and combine them all as variants. We will design our bar chart variant using auto layout, which means our bar chart are responsive. We can duplicate elements with ease because everything is built with auto layout. We will also learn more about the HSL colors and how to create reusable styles for our variant components. You can follow along in 15 easy steps. Step 1. So the first step is for us to create a rectangle. We do that by just simply drawing a rectangle. We can give it the height of 12 pixels. Also, we would go to the fill section, click on the fill, and let's choose a purple color by giving it like 268 in terms of hue and 80% in terms of saturation and 60% in terms of lightness. So we created the first portion of our progress bar. Step 2. All we need to do is to duplicate that holding option. And once we duplicate that, now we need to make this a bit lighter. Again, we would go on the fill. Instead of changing the hue saturation, we would go to the lightness and let's just change it to 90%. So right now we managed to create both of these. And the way it works is we do want this to grow and shrink because this is how progress bars work. So how do we do that? We can also first rename this to bar. So this means that each of these are one single bar that they get adjusted and resized accordingly. Step 3. What we need to do is we need to select both of them, shift and A to create an auto layout and rename this to bar by double clicking and then rename this to bar chart. So what you notice is if I now click on my bar chart and I try to resize this, my bar charts like the middle children elements, which are each bars, they are not resizing accordingly. Step 4. So in order for me to fix that, I have to go to the layer panels, making sure that I select both of the bars. And then on the right hand side here under the layout, we see that it is actually set to mix. And what we want, instead of actually being fixed, we would click on this and then making this fill. Under the layout panel, we have the ability to set this to fill. Again, if I try to remove this outside and duplicate this using option, I can use quick action and then just write remove all auto layout. And by doing that, now if I click on my bar chart, you see under my layout, I no longer have the option. So that is why it is important to use auto layout, because now if I click on my bar chart up top, I don't have the ability to resize it, even though I can resize it with constraints. I even have a 5-minute video explaining the difference between constraints and auto layout on my YouTube channel. However, this one, we're not going to explore the difference. We are going to use auto layout instead. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to delete the first one and select the second one, which is an auto layout frame. Step 5. Since we already created an auto layout and we already selected these two bars and we set it as fill, if we go ahead and select the parent, as you can see, if we try to resize this, both of them are being resized proportionately. This is exactly the behavior that we want, which means if we decide to have this at 10% and we want to make it grow every 10%, we just need to duplicate that 9 times. Step 6. So the way it works is here I added 100, which is 100%. If we decide to have every 10% for this bar to grow, we just simply need to divide this by 10. So right now we have 2, which is 8. All we need to do is select the lighter bar, hold Command and D multiple times. And as you can see, every time I press Command and D, that tiny bar gets smaller and smaller, and the sizing is all dynamic. Step 7. You can use a plugin called Layer Counter to see how many bars you have. So here we can highlight them, Command forward slash, visit the plugins, and then search for Layer Counter. Here, I can click on the 3 dots, view the details. This is the layer counter plugin that I use. So I can simply run this. As you can see, it tells me that I have 8 bars. So all I need to do is basically select the light one 2 more times and then Command and D to duplicate that. Now I have in total 10. So if I highlight everything and select them, here we see that we have 10 selected layers. Step 8. And in order for you to select everything from your layer panel, what you can do is select the first child, hold shift on your keyboard, and then go to your last element and then click while holding shift. This way you can select everything. Or you can simply select your parent, press return on your keyboard. And then as you can see, as soon as I press return on my keyboard, I'm able to select everything. Shift and return, I would select the top one. Return, I would select everything that is the children. And then as soon as I select it, it tells me that I have 10 bars. So I'm already happy with that. So I would close that. Also delete that because I had that for my reference. Now I need to repeat that 10 more times. And each time I need to increase the bar 1 step at a time. So here, this is 10% bar, step 9. So the next one, I would again hold option and drag this. And then I would just click here, click on this fill. I can use even the eye drop to basically select that. If I close that, now we see that our progress bar is taking shape, which means that the first bar is 10%, the second bar is 20%. But before we do that, we need to actually create some styles, step 10. This way, we no longer need to constantly go and click on the fill, adjust the colors. It is better to create reusable styles because we are trying to repeat that multiple times. Moreover, we also want to create dark mode and light mode. So if you don't have the pro version, you're not able to create variables in two different modes. Here we can create variables and simply add multiple modes. On the pro version, you can only add up to 4 modes. However, on the free version, I believe that you can only add 1 mode. So we can't really leverage the dark and light mode if we decide to use variables. So we're going to delete that. And we're going to approach this with just creating styles, which you can do in a free plan. So first thing first is we need to go on the local styles here. If you click outside of the canvas, you'd be able to see the local styles. You have to make sure you unselect everything. And then as soon as you see the local styles, you just click on the plus and it tells you to basically select one of these options. So we would go with the color and we have this pop up appear. So it tells us to rename your color and give it a description, which is optional. All we have to do is go and click on this and then use the eyedrop tool here. As soon as we use the eyedrop tool, we would be able to pick that color, or simply we can select it from here because this is the only colors that we use in the document. So both ways work. I would use the eyedrop to select the color from the bar chart. And then as you can see, I'm filtering by the HSL, not the hex code. So make sure you go and filter by HSL because we rename our colors based on the lightness. So here we have 60% in terms of the lightness value. So we need to rename this to purple and then we give it a 60% lightness value. Step 11. However, if you actually rename this using a forward slash like that, it would create a purple folder and it would place that 60% under that. So if we go ahead and do that and create that, right now you see we have a folder created called purple. And if I click on that tiny drop down, we have a color called 60%. So you can use that forward slash if you decide to have multiple values. In this case, we do want to have multiple values if you want to create dark mode and light mode. That's why I used the forward slash. So now since you have local styles created, you see that we have another tab called color styles. So now we can hover over the color styles and go and click the plus. And now we have again the same create new color style panel. We can click that. We can go and use the eyedrop. Go ahead and pick the lightness value of the purple, which is 90%. Click outside, rename this again to purple, all lowercase, again forward slash, and the lightness value is 90%. So as soon as we do that and follow this naming convention, we can create the style, and as you can see, it automatically added the color under the purple folder. So it is case sensitive, so we have to make sure to exactly follow the same colors. So right now what we can do is we can click on our bar chart, scroll down all the way. Instead of actually having these colors being randomly selected, we can click on that 4 dots. And as you can see, we have our library selected, which means now we can filter between the colors that we select from. So the one that we want to select is 90% for the lighter value. And then we select again on the 4 dots and go ahead and select 60%. Now our selection colors is different. As soon as we click on the bar chart and now we open it, it actually is pointing to reusable styles that we created. What you can do is you can always click on that tiny circle icon, and as soon as you do that, it actually selects all the colors that use the same style. So now you know that which Figma design elements are linked to this reusable style. So moreover, if I click outside, the way you would create a folder is by right clicking on the color styles. And as you can see, a pop up appears and it tells you to add a new folder. So here on the new folder, we would just need to rename this to light. So if we go ahead and rename this to light, we have again a light theme, and then we have again a folder called purple, because on the light theme, you might have again multiple colors. You might have a light theme of blue, a light theme of purple. And as you can see, you can keep adding them under the light theme. Moreover, what you can do is now if you click on the bar chart and if you scroll all the way down, you see now it actually added another forward slash for us, which is light forward slash purple and then forward slash the percentage of the color. So again, down the line, if we ever decide to change this, we can simply come here, change this from the style, and if we decide to go with another color, it would automatically update everywhere for us. Since we fixed this colors, now we can do is collapse all the layers using Option and L, hold Option to duplicate that, and every time we duplicate this, we would just click on one of these, and instead of 90, we change it to 60%. And then as you can see, as we try to duplicate that, select that tiny one, instead of 90%, we select 60. You can see our progress bar is actually shaping from 10% to 20% all the way to 30%. So we would repeat that all the way to 100%. So what I would do is I would fast forward this. Step 12. As you can see, we created 10 bar charts, and each time we add a color, again, we started from 0% and then we added 10%, 20%, all the way to 100%. Not only that, since we use auto layout, if I now highlight all of them and try to resize them, they are being resized dynamically. So no matter the screen size, this is always going to represent 10%. If your screen size is bigger, it is going to represent 10%. Again, this is the power of using auto layout to create your elements. Right now, we have to create our variants. In order for us to create our variants, we need to have components first. Since we selected our bar charts, the first thing we have to do is to create multiple components. We can do that by navigating to that three tiny dots. Once you select all your elements, you can click on the more action, then create multiple components, or simply use forward slash and search create multiple components, making sure not to select create components, because if you do that, it would create one giant component. You don't want that, so I'm going to command Z that, again, forward slash create multiple components. And as soon as I do that, I have 10 individual components created. As you can see, the master components, they have a different icon, which is a diamond icon with four tiny icons nested inside of them. Also, what you would notice is as soon as I have all of these selected as components, I have another option available for me, which is called combine as variants. This option is not going to be available for you if you don't have components created. Again, if I click outside, command Z that, now I'm back at auto layout. You see the icons of auto layout is different than the master components. And as soon as I hover over all of them and select them, you see I have again frame, and I don't have the option to create all of these as variants. So it is really important to use, again, create multiple components, step 13. Again, as soon as you do that, you see the icon is changed, and now I have the option to combine them as variants. And as soon as I click that and combine them as variants, you see that all of these components are now grouped under one master component, which is a bar chart component. Also, if I click on that tiny icon, you see now the icon of each variant is a bit different. It's actually a diamond, which is totally filled. That shows that this is one variant, which is nested inside a master component, which is called the bar chart. And what you notice is Figma gave them a default value at first. Also on the right hand side, as soon as I combine everything, Figma even gave me an error message that the properties are conflicting. So we have to resolve this issue. It is pretty to resolve this issue. As soon as you create your variants, all you have to do is give them each individual unique values, which means I would select the top one and I would just go under my default. Instead of having it as default, I would just click on that and give it 0%. Also, you can add anything under your value here. I just put 0. You can actually type in 0, or you can just have it as 0%. The values can be anything, so you can choose whatever that makes sense to you. But what you notice is we have again something called property. Figma also gave it a default value. We don't want that. So what we have to do is double click on the property and rename this to something that makes sense for our bar chart. So we would rename this to percentage. Now if I click outside and if I try to bring an instance out, the way you would bring an instance out, you have to hold option on your keyboard, drag an instance out. Now if you take a look at the left hand side, we have again three different icons. An instance icon is a diamond which is hollowed. A master component icon is an icon that is four hollowed diamond shapes, and a variant icon is an icon that is one diamond shape that is filled. So this is a very important way for you to tell a difference between an instance, a component, and a variant. So since we have our instance dragged out, you can see on the right hand side we have percentage and we have again a value of 0%. What you notice is I don't have the option to filter between different values because I didn't really assign values to the rest of the variant. So all I have to do is go to my second variant, and instead of again having this as default, we would just write 10%, press return, and I would fast forward that because all I have to do is click on each of them and then increase it by 10%. So here the other one is 20%. What you do notice is as soon as we have replace the default value, the layers also change on the left hand side. Here we have our bar chart. Even though that Figma gave them the default value, we renamed our variants here on the left hand side to 0%, 10%, and 20%, which means that if I now click on my instance again, we can tell that this is an instance by looking at it from the layer panel on the left hand side. Since I renamed three of my variants, if I click now, I have the ability to select between those three. Here now I can go 10% and you see my bar chart is updating, and then I can go 20% and you see it's updating every single time that I select a value for my variant. Not only that, since we built this with auto layout, you see it is being responsive regardless of your screen size. So I would go ahead again, select all of these variants one by one and gave them percentage value and fast forward. Step 14. Since I gave a value to all of my variants in my master component, if I take a look at the right hand side, the error is gone. So if you click on your master component, you see that you have a property called percentage and you have again 11 different values. You can always click on that tiny icon to see the properties. And what you notice is it is being ordered from 0% to 70%, and the 100% is being placed on top, which is a bit awkward. So what you can do is click and drag this all the way to the bottom and release this. By doing that, you're organizing your variants in terms of the value, which means that if I close this and if I click on my instance, now if I click on my right side, you see now I have the ability to switch between different progress bar. Here I can go 80%, I can go now switch between 40%, and also I have the ability to resize them. Step 15, don't forget to like and subscribe for more design tips and tutorials, and let me know what you think in the comments down below.